This is David C. Ward, a historian at the National Portrait Gallery of the Smithsonian Institution. What we really wanted to get to was a topic that's been hiding in plain sight for well over 100 years of American portraiture, which is the acknowledgement of the gay and lesbian presence in American art, a role which frequently isn't acknowledged. But more than that, what we wanted to do was to discuss the way in which sexual ambiguity and ambivalence becomes coded or threaded through portraits so that there's a personal element that transcends heterosexuality or gender or homosexuality to get to core questions of identity. It's not a show of gay and lesbian portraiture or a show of homosexual portraiture. It's dealing with a particular cast of mind, a particular attitude reflected in the art. We like the notion that something is hidden and you seek it, both in terms of the artists who are constructing paintings or photographs or videos, but then also the notion that the audience is coming to this to get a new look, a new reflection at works of art which have been in the public domain and famous for well over 100 years. We didn't want to do what you might expect. We didn't want to show art which was overtly sexualized, to sort of be a kind of reflexive that sexuality equals nudity, or that gender equals nudity, or that even personality and a love affair equals nudity. We wanted to show the range of aesthetic responses. We also wanted to focus on sort of mainstream themes of American art, because we wanted to show the way in which the canon, the way in which established major works of art have been only partially interpreted. This show has great art in it. It doesn't have, you know, marginalized art. It's not outsider art. It's not a specialist art show. This has a spine of artwork in it, which is in effect the spine of great American portraiture and artwork for the last 100 years. You know, the art stands on its own 2 feet. You might disagree with our interpretations of it, but the art essentially forces you to ask the question, how was it made? And we're saying that it's made in part because of profoundly deep and emotionally affecting issues of human identity.